Today's video would be Quizzer 1-3, Answer Key to Learning the Basics of Accounting by Rafael M. Lopez, 2020-2021 edition. Anyway, if you want to know the rest of the answers relating to this book, I have created a playlist. Just click the link above. Instruction: encircle or select the letter of the corresponding correct letter. Question number one. When was the year that accountancy profession was first recognized through the passing of accountancy law? The answer is letter B. Okay, it's 1923. Question number two. It is the field of professional practice where CPAs are considered as independent entity vested with freedom to exercise his own judgment and impartiality of the reports he prepared. A, that's government accounting. B, management accounting. C, private accounting. And letter D, public accounting. The answer is letter D, that's public accounting. Question number three. A CPA who chooses to join in the academe as a university professor, CPA reviewer, researcher, and so on, is a member of what sector? Again, in the CPA profession, there are four sectors. Okay, there are four sectors. You could be in the private accounting. You are under ACPASI. ACPASI stands for Association of CPA in Commerce and Industry. You could be in public accounting. That is, you are under the organization ACPAP. Association of CPA in Public Practice. Number three, that's government accounting. You are under GACPA, Government Association of CPA. And if you are in the academe, you are under the organization NACPAE, National Association of CPA in Education, or National Association of Certified Public Accountants in Education. So that means what? All CPAs are under PICPA. So, pag CPA ka, automatic under ka ng PICPA, Philippine Institute of Certified Public Accountants. And then, so that's the first organization that you are a member. Then second, depende na kung ano ang specific field na belong ka. So, nagtatrabaho ba ka ba sa government? So, you are under GACPA member. So, that means under ka ng PICPA at the same time, GACPA. So, kung ikaw naman ay nagtatrabaho as professor, that means under ka ng PICPA at the same time, NACPAE. So, as to the question, if you are a professor, so you are under NACPAE. Again, NACPAE stands for National Association of CPAs on Education. So, the answer is letter D, dog. Question number four. Many accountants are employed in business enterprise as chief accountant or controller. Said accountants are engaged in, so in this situation, you are a private employee of a specific company. So you are under private accounting. Question number five. The accredited national professional organization of CPA is, okay, so this is an organization in which lahat ng CPAs ay member dito. So the answer is PICPA. Okay? Kasi we are under PICPA pag you are a CPA in the Philippines. So the answer is DOG, Delta. Question number six. A CPA in public practice who examines financial statements and renders opinion that is free from bias is said to be engaged in what? Accordingly, this is in public practice. So this is under public accounting, okay? But what are examples of services under public accounting? If you are a public practitioner, that means what? Your clients are the public. So anyone could go to you to have your service. So you are just like parang lawyer ba na may sarili kang firm, tapos anyone can go for a legal advice. So in this perspective, accountant ka sa public, That means any clients could go to you. They could ask for what? Bookkeeping services, okay? Mag-prepare ka ng financial statement nila. Tax preparation, kasi hindi, bookkeeping services, kasi hindi naman lahat ng business ay may accountant talaga. Especially sa mga small and medium-sized enterprises. So kung wala silang financial statement, pwede silang lumapit sa iyo as public practitioner, magpapa-prepare sila ng financial statement. Management advisory services. So pag may problema sila about financial like financial problem, they don't know how to solve that one, they could ask for your advice. Okay? And you could also have what? Auditing renders, no? Auditing services. For example, this specific bank wants to loan a money from a bank. So may isang business gustong mag-loan sa isang bangko. Pero ano ang sabi ng bangko? Ma'am, kailangan namin ng financial statement. But it's just that yung financial statement is prepared by the company. So sometimes the bank would say, "Ma'am, hindi kaya biased tong financial statements?" What we want is what? Audited financial statement. So you as an auditor, this is where you come in. So what would happen? Ikaw yung mag-audit ng financial statement ng company. Okay? Tapos, pag audited na siya, saka pa ipo-forward sa bank. Ang sasabihin ng bank, okay, this is audited. That means what? Na-enhance na yung degree of confidence. Meaning, yung reliability ba? Kasi you are there as an auditor to enhance the degree of confidence. So, pag nag-auditing ka, that means what? Nag-e-express ka ng opinion na yun bang financial statement ng company is fairly presented. Okay? So, that would be discussed in higher auditing. But for the meantime, that's it muna. No, basta nag-audit ka, that means what? Nagre-render ka ng opinion sa financial statement. Okay? So, and of course, others. There are other services that are not being mentioned. So, for this one, you render an opinion, so that's boy, auditing. Question number 7. Does a pay board examination covers how many subjects? The answer is 6 subjects. That's letter A. That's FAR, Financial Accounting and Reporting, AFAR, Advanced Financial Accounting and Reporting, MS, Management Services, Auditing, Taxation, RFBT. RFBT stands for Regulatory Framework and Business Transactions. Ang former name ng RFBT is Business Law. Okay, so 2 subjects po yan every day. So 3 days yung exam. Question number 8. Any person applying for examination shall establish the following requisites to the satisfaction of the board that he or she is what? Well, according to the requirement, that he or she is a Filipino citizen, is of good moral character, is a holder of degree of BSA, okay, and has not been convicted of any criminal offense involving moral turpitude. So, letter A, kasama po yan. B, kasama yan. C, kasama yan. So, the answer is all of the above. Okay. Question number 9. Which of the following is not a qualification of an applicant for the CPA licensure examination? So, ano yung hindi kasama sa requirement? Good moral character, kasama yan. Letter C, kasama yan. Filipino citizen and a holder of BSA. So, hindi kasama is at least 21 years of age. So, it's not part of the requirement. Question number 10. Which of the following is correct? The answer is letter C. Okay, what makes letter A incorrect? Accordingly, letter A says, the examination in which the candidate was conditioned and the removal examination of the subject in which he or she failed shall be counted as 2 complete examination. This would be further discussed later, pero ano ang false letter A? Kasi it will be counted as 1 complete examination, hindi po 2. Okay, 1 lang. That would be discussed later. Statement B, what makes B as false? Any candidate who fails in two complete CPA board examinations will no longer be allowed to take another set of examinations. Okay, that's false. Again, unlimited po ang CPA board exam. Kahit 100 times ka na mag-take, allowed po yan. It's just that, pag nag-fail ka 2 times, okay, kailangan mong mag-refresh your subject ng at least 24 units. Then take ka ulit. Pag nag-fail ka ulit ng 2 times, refresh your subject naman ulit, and take ka ulit. So unlimited, it's just that for 2 consecutive failure, you need to have a refresher subject of 24 units. So that's why the answer is letter C. 11. The Board of Accountancy shall be composed of a chairman and how many members? So, 1 chairman and 6 members. Letter C. Again, si Boa yung nagpre-prepare ng CPA board exam. No? CPA licensure examination. So, 1 chairman and 6 members. 12. A conditioned candidate shall take an examination in the remaining subjects. Okay. Allow me to discuss what do you mean by conditional, sir. Okay. Accordingly, rating in the licensure examination. To be qualified as having passed the licensure examination for accountants, first, a candidate must obtain a general average of 75% with no grades lower than 65%. So, in any given subject. In the event a candidate obtains the rating of 75% and above in at least a majority of subjects as provided in this act, he or she shall receive a conditional credit for the subjects passed, provided that a candidate shall take an examination in the remaining subject within 2 years from the preceding examination. So, what do you mean by this? Meaning, may tatlong status. Pass, failed, conditional. So pag conditional ka, hindi ka nag-pass, hindi ka rin nag-fail. Conditional means what? May mga subject kang ipinasa at may mga subject na nag-fail. So kailangan mong i-retake ang exam pero hindi lahat ng subject. 'Yun lang yung subject na kung saan nag-fail ka. At yung pag-retake mo, ang tawag doon removal yung removal exam mo, together with your first exam, kung saan nag-conditional ka, is considered as one exam. So, conditional ka, first take, that means may pumasa ka na subject ang iba hindi. I-retake mo yung hindi pumasa, provided na within 2 years, dapat i-retake mo talaga siya. Okay? Let's have an example here. Situation, so, let us just say you have 6 subjects. Tax, auditing, MS, RFBT, FAR, AFAR. Then you have your average. Situation A. Nakakuha ka ng 95% sa dalawang subject mo at 65% sa apat na subject mo. Pass ba? Yes, pass. As long as walang below 65 at yung average mo is 75 and up, pasa. Situation 2. 75, 85, 75, 65, 65, 65. Sir, as to individual subject, pumasa ka. No grade below 65. Pero yung average mo, maliit lang. 71, hindi pumasa. So, failed ka. Situation C, yung individual grade mo, may hindi pumasa. 55%. At yung average mo, hindi rin pumasa. 71.50%. Supposedly, failed ka na nito. But then again, anong sabi ng standard? Kapag majority sa inyong subject ay at least 75%. And when we say majority, how does accounting define majority? 50% plus 1. Since there are 6 subjects, ano ba ang 50% plus 1? Out sa 6. Yung 50% ng 6 is 3, di ba? Plus 1, 4. So, at least 4 subjects mo ay 75%. Conditional ka. So, that's why sa situation C, you are a conditional passer. Sa situation B, sir, bakit hindi ako conditional? Kasi tatlo lang yung at least 75% mo. Well, sa situation C, apat. So, majority. Sa situation D, the same lang sa situation C, majority sa inyong subject ay at least 75%. It's just that yung average ay magkaiba. Ang average sa letter D, pumasa, 78.17%. While ang average mo sa letter C, hindi pumasa, 71.50%. So, same status, conditional, pero magkakaiba sila kung ano yung subject na i-retake mo. Sa letter situation C, yan po yung situation 2. Na pag ang average mo is less than 75%, kailangan mong i-retake ang lahat ng iyong subject less than 75%. So ano ba yung subject na less than 75%? Far at afar. Okay? Anong reason behind? Kasi nga, alanganin yung average mo. So kung gusto mong makabawi, gusto pumasa talaga, kasi alanganin yung average mo. So lahat na ng subject below 75%, i-retake mo na. Para pag mag-average later, eh, mas malaki yung chance na yung average is more than 75%. Sa situation D, okay na yung average, di ba? 78% na. So ano ang kailangan mong i-retake? Yun lang yung subject na below 65%. Kasi yun lang naman talaga ang kailangan. No grade below 65%. Kaya sa situation D, ano ang i-retake mo? Far lang. Okay, financial accounting and reporting. So, that should be taken within what? 2 years from the preceding examination. So, okay lang, hindi ka mag-take sa next, every 6 months naman yan, 2 exam per year. So, pagka next, hindi ka rin mag-take kasi gusto mo talagang mag-review. Pero huwag mong palagpasin ng 2 years. No? Question 13. How many calendar years that the Board of Accountancy shall submit to the Professional Regulatory Commission the ratings that the candidate obtained during the board exam? The answer is letter C, 10 calendar days. So, ang kinagandahan ng CPA exam class is that yung time of waiting is konti lang. Maximum of 10 days, may result na. Okay? But it's within 10 days, ha? It doesn't mean na kailangan talaga 10 days. Sa akin ang time, within 3 days lang, may result na. So, pwede within 5 days lang, may result na. Within 6 days, may result na. Basta maximum of 10 calendar days, sure yan, may result na. Question 14. Due to the creation of FRSC, the Accounting Standards Council Statement of Financial Accounting Standards, or SFAS, are now being renamed as PAS. Okay, Philippine Accounting Standards. Question 15. The members of the Professional Regulatory Board of Accountancy shall be appointed by the, again, President of the Philippines. The Board of Accountancy shall be composed of a chairman and 6 members to be appointed by the President of the Philippines upon recommendation of the PRC. Kasi hindi man talaga kilala ni President lahat ng mga ex na mga magagaling na CPA. So at least may recommendation galing kay PRC. Okay, the answer is D. 16. A professional accountant in public practice is prohibited from divulging any confidential information as a result of professional and business relationship to third parties without a specific authority from the management. The answer is B, confidentiality. So tama po yan. No, pag tayo ay public practitioner, may mga private businesses na nagpapa-audit sa atin. Yung information nila na ino-audit sa atin is confidential po yun. We are not allowed to disclose that one to their competitor or to others na walang pahintulot galing sa kanila. Okay? Number 17. A professional accountant should not allow bias, conflict of interest, or undue influence of others to override professional or business judgment. The answer is objectivity. Being objective is the opposite of being subjective. As human as we are, sometimes we tend to be subjective. Ah, close kami nito. Malapit siya sa akin. So parang subjective na yan. But when you decide, when you judge professionally, it should be objective. Based on facts, based on information, based in history, and not based on feelings. So that's being objective as a professional. That ends for today's video. That's the answer for quizzer 1-3 of Learning the Basics of Accounting by Rafael M. Lopez, 2020-2021 edition. If you want to know the rest of the answers relating to this book, I have created a playlist. Just click the link above. Thank you and God bless.